If I could sing, this would be a song. Instead, it's Sunday. And I'm either 7 or 8, doesn't really matter. I'm too young to touch the stove, the grits are popping. As a mother's voice attempts to drag my brother from top the staircase, where he complains about his slacks hang too high above his ankles. My pops is in the living room, opening mail, muttering something about electricity, to which my mother exclaims, "What else are we supposed to do about Tennessee Southern heat?" Then turns down the air conditioner, and now we're in the car. The ding of my brother's Game Boy is a malignant rooster. Wake me up from my backseat pre-church slumber, and out the window, there is a cloud in sight, to which I figure, this must be a day the Lord has made. The pews always creak the loudest. We walk in late, so we wait just outside the front door for the pastor, for the choir to sing their first note. They're taking a while this morning. I can feel the sweat getting to bucket in the back of my penny loafers. My mother say she could see through the stained glass window a young girl walking up to the microphone. It turns out it's Tasha, aka Little Osh, her family stay at 28 around the corner of the city's convenience store. Her father died 2 years ago today from cancer. Something like it. Either way, his body not here anymore. Sometimes Little Osh sings a song in his place. Today, that song is Amazing Grace. Doors swing open as organs play. Little Osh sings her first note right there in front of the 6-foot crucifix that Pastor bought last winter with the money we raised from the summertime picnic. But coincidentally, Little Osh's voice is the only holy thing anyone could find worth worshiping. And now, the entire church is crying to Little God. Did another bad thing he ain't quite yet answered for. And this little girl's red marble raw fro ain't fit to let it go. So she sang some mo. My mother catches the Holy Ghost, something like it. And if I could sing, this would be a song. But instead, I'm 26 on a Monday afternoon. The heat isn't southern, but it's still hot enough to coax the skin beneath my clothes. My mother is still filled with a ghost, or should I say spirit? At least that's what the awning reads. Lies on the floor before me. A bottle of Bacardi perched to her lips as she's trying to siphon the music out of it. Ain't the kind of melody she needs. So I play her favorite gospel, Silver and Gold, and the woman singing hits a note that can sweep an entire church basin clean. So I just bow. She just bows to her knees and beats a river of spilled brown liquor onto 38th Street and pleads, "God, just bring him back to me." And I start crying, "Oh God, did another bad thing he ain't quite get answer for him. This little quite get answer for him. This were a song, I swear, though my mom's I was singing it, because who needs a God when it's a choir that saves us? So hold the cross. I pray to the trumpet. I pray to the tambourine. I say, kill the father and place a song in space and leave behind. But this is the day our pain has made. And fuck it, I'm singing. And fuck it, I'm singing. And fuck it. I'd rather have Jesus than silver and gold."